You know how a woman, whenever you feel like your husband is cheating, even though you haven't caught him red-handed, you know, you have this feeling somehow. The spirit will just minister to you that this man is playing games on top of your matter. You get? Hi guys, good afternoon, and you're welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Irene, and I'm a lifestyle vlogger based in Osaka, Enugu State of Nigeria. If you're seeing me for the first time, hi, hello, you're welcome. Please have it. It's okay. Get your popcorn. Get your juice or wine or whatever, beer, and relax, okay, and keep watching. To my OGs, you guys, you guys, thank you so much for always being there for me, okay. In my last video, the one I talked about, the question and answer video, a lot of you asked that I film a video of why I got drunk and when I got drunk. So that's why I've come to, you know, to tell you guys everything surrounding that drunkenness and what happened and why I got drunk. So if you don't know, I'm not really the kind of person that drinks excessively, okay? I kind of give myself respect, yes. So and it wasn't my first time taking alcohol. It's not like I took alcohol so much and then, or it was my first time taking alcohol and then I got drunk. No, it wasn't. So if you don't know, I started drinking alcohol from when I was a child, like from when I was young. See, here in Nigeria, is in the abroad that you're going to see somebody, don't give your child alcohol because of her brain. Don't give your, I don't know, here in Nigeria it's not really like that. Even though you're not going to give that child excess alcohol, but somehow parents here, they tend to give their child just little, sometimes a sip, sometimes a test, so that child, you know. So it wasn't like it was my first time. I just want to give you a background check on my alcohol life, like, you know. So I've been taking alcohol from when I was even a child. Like, it wasn't a big deal for me, but I don't take it excessively so much so that I started disgracing myself, you know. And when I got drunk, it wasn't like I was outside. It wasn't like we went out to have a drink and I got there and overdrank and then started misbehaving. No, it wasn't like that. So it's still about my abusive ex. Yeah, it happened that I've been having this, you know how a woman, whenever you feel like your husband is cheating, even though you haven't caught him red-handed, you know, you have this feeling somehow, the spirit will just minister to you that this man is playing games on top of your matter. You get? And you just feel it. So I was feeling that way for a very long time, and whenever I asked him, he would say, no, why are you thinking like that? Why are you always feeling like that? You know, you have trust issues, you don't even trust yourself, you know, stuff like that. He would turn everything back at me and make me look like I was having trust issues. So sometimes I'll just tell myself, since I haven't caught him, let me just forget about this thing and just, you know. So sometimes I wouldn't ask him, how are you coping? I know it's not easy for men to cope, you know, without sex, especially somebody who is married. How are you coping staying this long time, you know, without a woman? How are you coping? You say that he talks to himself, you know, however he talks to himself, that I shouldn't bother, that he's fine, that he doesn't have any girl, any friend or anything. So, you know, and then I felt like maybe I should just let this matter die, you know. So I kind of trusted him, and I told myself, why am I having all these, you know, trust issues? I'm here and I'm not doing anything, so why would I feel like he's there and he's doing something? So yeah, I forced myself to trust him, okay. So it happened that he came home one time, and there's this girlfriend of his former ex-girlfriend though, which he keeps telling me that they are just friends, that there's nothing between them, that they don't have anything, you know, they're just friends. You see, don't ever trust a man with ex-girlfriend or ex-friend. It's my friend, it's my bestie. Do not trust it though, honestly, I'm telling you. So he kept telling me that, and I believed him, up until one time he came home and he was pressing his phone. He, first of all, I don't touch his phone whenever he comes back. Like, I'm giving ultimatum never to touch his phone, so I don't touch it. But he has every right to touch my own phone and do whatever he wants to do with my phone, but I wasn't allowed to touch his own phone. So he came back that time and was giving me face. You know when you're doing everything to please somebody and that person is just doing like, you know. So I was just noticing the distance between us, and I felt like, wow. I mean, when a man stays out this long and comes home, there should be this spark, there should be this, you know, excitement between the two of you, but that excitement wasn't there. If you're hearing a background noise, I'm so sorry. Oh no, that period, so instead of us to have this connection, this, you know, there was distance, there was kind of gap, and I was worried what could be the problem. I tried doing a whole lot of things that wives do to get the attention of their husband, but pew, it wasn't working. So at this point, I felt like something is wrong, something is going on. If I tried touching his phone, he said, no, I shouldn't touch his phone. That you gave me the audacity to touch his phone. I'm not allowed that until he see me start trusting myself or start trusting him. That's when he's going to allow me to touch his phone. It wasn't about him again. Now it was not about me. So if anytime I learn to trust him, that's the time he will not allow me to touch his phone. Imagine. So I said, okay. So one day I was gisting him things that would be happening in the neighborhood. You know, I was just telling him everything that's been going on since he wasn't around. And he was so busy pressing his phone. Like, you know, when you're talking to somebody, that person is like, okay. Yes, I'm listening. I'm hearing you. You know? Ah, God. I felt so mad. Why am I talking to this man? This man is busy pressing his phone. So at that point, I just, you know, squeezed the phone out of his hand and I ran to my mom's room because I was living with my mom. So I ran to my mom's room and I bolted the door. And I wanted to find out what was in that phone that was making him so... He was concentrating so much on the phone and not on me that he hasn't seen for almost a year. You get? So when I opened the phone, to my surprise, like, I've never been so shattered all my life. I've never been so broken, so disappointed, so... I opened the phone and then what I saw is... I saw something that I don't know how I feel right now. So he was telling the person, his ex-girlfriend, which he has been telling me all these years, that there was nothing between them. They were just friends. There was nothing. Okay. He was telling her that he can't wait to be with her. That she knows how it used to be for them, you know, as far sexually. That he knows how it used to be. That he'll be coming to Onitsha, because this girlfriend, ex-girlfriend of his, is married and is living in Onitsha. That he'll be coming to Onitsha. That he will spend 3 days in Onitsha with her. That he can't wait to be with her. And that... he can't wait to be with her, and when he comes, that they're going to, you know, have fun and be, you know, enjoy themselves. So this woman was like telling her, wow, this one that you're chatting with me so free like this, it's like your wife is not around. He said, don't mind that one. I can treat her fuck up, you know. That one said, okay, no problem. So that one was like, said, okay. So that one said, you know, my husband is around. I won't sleep over in the hotel with you, but I'll be coming and I'll be going. He said, no problem, that after their stay, that he'll now be going from there, that he'll act like he has gone. And then they're going to have time for themselves. Then from there, he will go back. Yeah. It felt like 1,000 daggers was just, you know, stabbing me all over. At that point, I felt like, wow. So all this while, I've just been stupid. I feel like, oh. So all this time. So all this time. I've just been so ignorant. So, like, so dumb. You know? And do you know that while I was still reading this conversation, even it got to a point, that was the one I just read that time. I was trying to scroll up to see every other conversations when he broke the door. Like, he literally used his leg like this and hit the door, because I bolted it from inside. He broke the door and came inside and gave me the beating of my life. Like, I've never been so humiliated all my life. Before my mother, before my two kids, that time my first daughter was alive, before my maid, my help, somebody who was helping me that time, he came into the room. Before my mother, no respect at all. He slapped me and gave me the beating of my life. And then locked the whole door so that I couldn't leave. I wanted to, you know, go out, leave the house for him and just go out. But he locked the whole doors and held the key. He didn't want me to go out. He didn't want me to go and maybe probably tell people or something. I don't know. He just didn't let me go out. So I was so mad. I was so unhappy that, you know, sometimes when you're unhappy like this, you kind of do something that you regret later on. You kind of, your actions that time, you might do something you regret later on, okay? So at that point, I was so unhappy. There's this herb You guys, you already know that I'm a herbalist. I make herbs, okay? So there's this herb I prepared to prevent me from getting pregnant, because at that time I didn't want to get pregnant, because it felt like what I now do in that marriage was just get pregnant, have children, get pregnant, have a child, get pregnant. You know, sometimes people start insulting me, telling me, after all, you're married, your husband would have not seen your husband. Oh, you're every year you're pregnant, you know. So I said that year, that time that is going to come, but at me, I'm not going to get pregnant, okay? Unfortunately, I still got pregnant with my son that day. No, not unfortunately. Fortunately, God forbid that I would regret having my son. Hey, won't call mom. Is it lie? So, yeah. Anyway, so there's this herb I prepared then that was supposed to prevent me from getting pregnant. So that herb, you pour a hot drink. You use hot drink to mix it. Okay. So I was so upset I went and carried that hot drink and I was just drinking it. I felt like it was going to make me get better. It was going to make me feel better or something. So I was just drinking. I didn't know when I finished the whole bottle. When I realized what I did to myself was when my head was now doing like this. Like, I didn't know where I was again. I started talking stupidly. I even started telling my daughter, be strong. You're the adult of this house. That time my first daughter was alive. I said, be strong, you're there of this. Take care of your sister. Take care of everybody here. Even if you don't see me, just be strong. Be strong. That was how I got drunk. And I didn't get myself to the following day. I was vomiting all over. I was just, thank God my mom was around, because maybe if she wasn't around, maybe, I just don't know. It's only God that knew. So thank God my mom was around, so they were just cleaning everything up and, you know, trying to make me feel better. So the time I realized myself was the following month. So the following morning when I woke up, I felt a little better, even though I had serious headache. So I woke up the following morning and that was it. I just realized that there was no need fighting. There was no need trying to be somebody's all. You know, when that person doesn't want to be your all, you get. So it was at that point that I called myself general meeting and told myself, see, Adibi, you died. You are drinking alcohol on somebody's matter. Adibi, you died. That chapter would have been closed. JJ. By now, a lot you cannot remain like that now. You get me? So it was at that, this thing happened in 2018. It was still that same year I lost my daughter. 2018 was too much. Anyway, so it was after that point that I told myself, nah, why are you even drinking past time of another person's headache? Just let this man be. He will never change. He will never change. But can you believe that? Few days after the thing, probably he thought the alcohol messed with my head or I wasn't thinking straight anymore. He said, why are you giving yourself headache? You're just giving yourself headache for nothing. You did not even see anything in my phone and you're so unhappy. You did not see anything on my phone. What is there? Meanwhile, he has deleted everything that I saw, even the one that I didn't read. All the conversation, he deleted them. Ha! People can be crook in this life. People. He deleted all these conversations, everything. I said, look at my phone, look at it. Did you see anything? There's nothing here. You're just giving yourself headache for nothing. Trying to brainwash me into believing that I did not see anything again. Trying to brainwash me into thinking that nothing happened, that I did not see anything. Eh? You see, this life, eh? You know, balance. So, yeah, that was how I actually got drunk. That was the first and last time I'm ever going to get drunk, okay? Because I don't think anybody's going to help me that much again, because this life, I've decided to tell myself, just expect the worst, okay? Just, anything can happen. People can change. Somebody might promise heaven and earth to you today and tomorrow, the person will change. So, are you going to kill yourself each time somebody makes promises to you and then that person doesn't keep it? You won't. So, you have to keep living, okay? The only one that matters is that one that you kept to yourself, that one, that promise you made to yourself. That's when, so I don't know what you're going through. I don't know what you've already gone through, whether you've been in my situation before or not. Honestly, if you've not, thank God, please. I know it's not something I wish on anybody to go through, okay? So thank you so much for watching my video. If you did enjoy this video, please give this video a thumbs up, okay? Please share this video too, okay? And See, there are a lot of stories surrounding this story that I just said, but I just told you the part where I got drunk so that you're going to understand, okay? I don't know. I've decided I'm going to go live. If I want to talk about my ex-marriage, you know, I just have to go live where we can have a one-on-one conversation about it instead of just, you know, taking, you know, I just felt like going live would be better, where I can just pour out my feelings to you guys. What do you guys think, okay? And that way you guys can support me too. So thank you so much for watching. If you've watched to this point, I love you all, okay? Look, I am happy now. Forget that somehow emotions came while I was filming this video. I am so happy now. Like, I've never been this happy, this fulfilled, like I feel right now, okay? I'm no longer bothered about what he does or what he do. It doesn't concern me anymore, okay? So my happiness now is no longer tied to him. So I am happy where I am. So do not feel pity for me. I feel like I'm hurting or something. I'm not. I am, honestly, I'm not, okay? So thank you so much. I'll see you in my next video.